We turn now to conscious uncoupling. Actress Gwyneth Paltrow bringing the term into the spotlight, using it to describe her split with husband Chris Martin. ABC's Nick Watt has a look at what the phrase really means.
Conscious uncoupling. That's what Gwyneth Paltrow and Chris Martin say they're up to. Not divorce, conscious uncoupling. As Gwyneth danced with Glee on Glee the other night, I wondered, what does conscious uncoupling actually mean?
I think the most healthy way to define conscious uncoupling is that we agree to separate. You're not going to fight. You're not going to argue about money.
So it's a constructive, respectful, and private alternative to, let's say, the Charlie Sheen and Denise Richards route of courtrooms and custody battles. With the divorce rate at 50% and climbing, maybe we should all read this essay posted by Paltrow, written by two relationship therapists who proclaim it's conscious uncoupling that prevents families from being broken by divorce. They say we're now just living too long. Life expectancy was under 50 in 1900 and now it's up around 80, and we just weren't designed to be married that long. As Paltrow told me just a few months ago,
it's not easy to be married for 10 years.
Apparently 10 years was enough. The couple said in their Splitsville statement, while we love each other very much, we will remain separate. We are, however, and always will be a family. And in many ways, we are closer than we have ever been.
I felt actual sincerity in the message. Will this be Alec Baldwin and Kim Basinger? There is not a chance.
Every time we've seen Paltrow and Martin together recently while they were working out the end of their relationship, I must say, they did look rather happy. For Good Morning America, Nick Watt, ABC News, Los Angeles.
And we're going to bring in child development specialist Dr. Robin Silverman for more on conscious uncoupling and what it could mean for...
Thank you for having me.
Shed some more light into this.
So conscious uncoupling is a positive term used for divorce that's amicable and responsible and blame-free.
And Gwyneth and Chris, you could tell they put a lot of thought into this.
That's right. That's right. I think that the idea of divorce is so laden with baggage, and especially when it's coupled with Hollywood, we think of fly-by-night marriages, breakups that happen on a moment's notice. And by saying conscious uncoupling, they're divorcing themselves from that term divorce and saying, we're doing this together, we're doing this consciously, and we're doing this for the betterment of our family.
So it seems communication then here is the key. It's really the basis of all of this. As a child development specialist then, taking this approach and having that be the focus, the preface really, if you will, how does it impact the children?
Well, children obviously get impacted by divorce no matter what. But when parents are on board with positive co-parenting, with understanding that they need to be respectful to one another, not using their children as pawns and jumping in and arguing, it's going to affect the children much more positively than if they're going to be really horrible to one another.
And even in the split itself, my divorce, we actually used a mediator, and it created an air of just cooperation from the beginning.
Exactly.
And that has worked for my family as well. So I appreciate this term, whatever you want to call it. It's so much nicer than what we can see on the other side.
Absolutely. I think people think about marriage and the amount of work it needs to go into marriage, but we don't often talk about the amount of work it takes to have an amicable divorce.
Yes. Yep.
And we need to be very conscious of that, especially when there's children involved.
It's really about giving children the opportunity to model love,
You've said that before. I love that idea. And I just want to ask, if you're not in the most friendly place, is it possible to get to this conscious uncoupling place? Can you sort of restart?
I think you can. I think you need to come together and say, let's do this over. Let's remember that we're doing this for the betterment of our family and that we're two people. We both can be responsible. We don't have to point fingers, and we can do this in a way that's really great for everyone.
It's not about somebody winning.
You want the kids to win.
Yep.
You do. You want the kids to win.
And it's understanding. You're always going to be a family.
Yep,
you
that's
will.
Right.
And
exactly.
so it's taking the best approach there. Yeah.
That's right. We know that when we have kids, they're always looking to us about how we're going to behave, and that becomes the template for how they will behave.
Because we showed Alicia Keys with her ex, her husband's ex, and the children all together vacationing, and how a good environment that was.
It's
It can happen.
It can happen if we make a conscious attempt to make
it happen.
Really
great advice.
Thanks,
Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
We'll see you again soon.
Thank you.